The best thing you can do is talk about it in your group, to look in your own examples, look at your own graphs, look at your own assignments, look at your own book and read it yourself and figure it out. Someone has already told you how to do this. People should stop telling you at this point. You're not going to remember it if you just keep writing what I write.
Okay.
You should use your resources to find it. So, and that's kind of like a daily thing, like if info, where you're just waiting for me to write answers. You're doing the least effective method of class. So it's to find them yourself. Okay. So on number one, this comes out of chapter 7.2. This is when we did the simple rational functions. When I see number one, I see an up and down line at 4, and a right left line at 3. I see that it has a negative, so I'm picturing this graph. Okay, just a reminder, that's what number one shows. You guys got it. And vertical asymptote is at x equals 4, or horizontal asymptote is at y equals 3. Good job. Number two, your vertical asymptotes, and this is a more complicated graph, so both of these come out of chapter 7.3. The vertical comes from the bottom. So I have to solve the bottom to get the vertical. I'm going to have to factor and solve. Should I wait? So I see a mistake here and here. Should I wait? Do you guys want a little bit more time to use your resources and then figure it out?
Yeah.
Let me wait. Look at 7.3. There's a graphing assignment. I mean, you're are for the most part right.
Oh, she was there.
Yeah, I was like.
Exponents. The plus and minus are in the three is going to be a dash line. Nine is going to be a dot at 9, 0, and a dot at -9, 0.
Oh.
Points. Dot lines. The top makes points, not dash lines. Dash lines come from the bottom and compare. We've spent 2 days factoring, crossing out. We did it with one fraction, we did it with a multiplication between them, and we did it with division. We flipped, factored, and crossed out. Let me see your work from that. I didn't grade it yesterday. I did a 6 in class with you, so even if you didn't do your homework and not your classwork, I'll give you credit for that part. I haven't given you credit for it yet. I'm keeping it secret. So you know where you're headed.
I'm going to take someone in second period.
Get off your tech.
It's not sausage time.
Do you have anything from the
okay, let's do it. I don't really know. So what do you do after this? Oh, we can. All right, for the correcting the mistakes, here's the answers. Oh, there's 20 and there's 22. The 22 looks tricky.
Okay, I did not get.
Alright, everyone got every group who got extra credit, it's gonna show up in the assignment column. So when I put assignments in for quarter four, let's say it's worth 32 points, it'll look like 34 out of 32. That extra credit. If you did all of them.
I'll get extra credit.
Everybody in the groups who went to the board.
Not the extra credit.
Yes, oh, yeah. I will put that in before the
board. Why don't you go?
But I'd like to put it in.
Exactly.
And give you somebody to see it. We'll see.
Then
it
gets with
it. Who's got a question?
Does it have to go with both
of them? It has to multiply to be this one, 9 times 9. And then they have to add to be this one.
And then you just cross out whatever. For the top, do you have to, like, for the x plus 4, and then there's an x plus 2 and x minus 9? You can't, like, cross out them at the same time. Right. So, like, if the 2 was a 4, you can cross it out at the same time.
Alright, today we're doing 7.5. We're moving to adding and subtracting.
Multiplying and dividing.
Pretty much relying on the factoring skills. Adding and subtracting combines factoring and common denominators.
So what
I will do is as we get into these, so the whole chapter's fractions. You know, we graph these fractions, we're reducing fractions, and now we're adding them. What I will do is I will go back to these basic examples that you've done for a long time. Because your brain, the first time you do this, it doesn't recognize what's happening. Because it looks so much more complicated, but you recognize those. You've done those fractions for years. So I will tell you, we'll go back to a simple one, look at the process, and apply it here.
So all fractions need common denominators. If you're going to add or subtract, you got to get a common denominator. Like, number one already has that common denominator of 5, so we just add or subtract the numerator. So, number one is just 4/5. Add across the top. Yeah. Right now in third grade they're reducing fractions in third grade right now. They have not added yet.
What?
Do you like look at their math?
I love it. You do math problems for fun?
Yeah. Oh, in your free time?
Cried at the kitchen table over math homework.
Challenge to add. You can't add if it's not like terms. So my answer will just be the numerators together over 2. Let's talk common denominator. Am I going through that?
Okay, I'm good.
Okay, a common denominator is actually called a least common multiple. So when you read the section and the directions will ask for a least common multiple, what they're saying is, what would the common denominator be? A least common multiple is a high number, which is confusing because the word says least. But it's a high number that both numbers can divide into. So, try number one. What do you think the common denominator should be on number one?
Hooray. You get extra credit for that.
Now, would 30 work?
Yeah.
30 would work, but we couldn't call it the least common multiple. It's just a common multiple. That's why the word least is in there. Not because it's a low number. It's just the lowest of the high numbers. All right, so we're going to have a 15. And a 15. All right. 1/3 into 15, I'd have to multiply it by 5. So we have to also multiply the top by 5. So 1/3 is the same as 5/15.
Wait, what is?
In order to turn 5 into 15, I'd have to multiply it by 3. So I have to multiply the top by 3. 3/15 is the same as 1/5. Now that we have a common denominator, we add across the top, and here's our sum. Like when I add these fractions together, what will I make the denominator? So my LCM is 12. How do I turn 6 into 12? Well, I have to multiply it by 2, so I also multiply the top by 2. The second one doesn't change at all. Add across the top, 7/12. What's my common denominator on 3, Natalie?
Oh.
I don't really know.
Six.
6x.
Hooray!
You guys, if they throw a variable in there, it has to be in your common denominator. You can't just exclude it. So if you're coming up with a least common multiple, you have to include the variables present. So our least common multiple between 6x and 6 is 6. So the first fraction doesn't have to change. The second one didn't have x in it originally, so I'll multiply it to the top and bottom. So that'll make it 7x. I gotta add across the top. Where? In the box, you think? Well, this is connected to a plus sign, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
So, in standard form, does the variable go first or the code go
first? Like,
yeah. You can put that song.
Okay, so it doesn't matter? Like, the imaginary numbers?
Right.
So, here's some tips for you when it comes to denominators. I got 2 tips for you. If there's variables present, every variable has to be shown in your LCM. And you want to pick the highest exponent that you see. Okay, so for your LCM, choose every variable and its highest exponent. Also, if you can factor, you need to include every factor. So when you're picking a least common multiple and you have variables and factors involved, pick every variable, pick its highest exponent, pick every factor. So, for example, let's say I had to add these 2 fractions. I got 5x to the 3rd y. I got 10x y to the 4th.
OCM, Adrian. Between 5 and 10, what would the LCM be? 10, pick a high number. I also have to include X. I'm going to pick X to the third, because that's the highest exponent I see. I also have to include Y. I'll do Y to the fourth, because that's the highest exponent I see. That's my LCM. You pick the number like you always have. Pick every variable, you pick the highest power. So go ahead and try number one. What you're doing is you're pretending that those are denominators. If these were denominators, what would the common denominator be? You can, if it helps. I do. If you imagine it's not going to show you as fractions today, because actually today we're not going to actually make you add these. On day one, we just say, can you come up with a common denominator? So yeah, Berlin is 30. Because of the 5 and the 6, you pick 30, a high number they both divide into. And it's x squared. And it's just y by itself. So this is well, let's look at number two. It presents differently. Same concept, but you have to factor. Well, right, this little guy can be factored. Trust me, it does to be factored. If it can be factored, you must factor it. Think about it in factored form. So how do we factor 3x squared plus 3x? It's a GCF. 3x is our GCF. And what would be left in parentheses? X plus 1. So you don't wanna try to pick an LCM until you're in factored form. From my LCM. First, I just look at the 9 and the 3. What's the LCM with 9 and 3? 9. Got it. Then I look at the x squared and the x. Better pick x squared. Last, I go to x plus 1. I have to list every factor. There it is. If I had to add two fractions and these were the denominators, that would be my common denominator. There's two more for you to try. Where did what come from? Do you know where this came from? This is it. My LCM has to show everything. So if this is here, it has to show up in my least common multiple. Where did I get this green thing? Looking at this, there's a GCF. You can pull a 3 out. You can pull an X out.
I think there's a 3X inside here. Right? Because 3 goes into 9. And X goes into X squared. Natalie, you finished? What are you doing? What's wrong?
Do you only keep like one of the numbers? Oh, yeah. So, step one, factor. How do we factor 2x minus 2?
We take the 2 out.
How do we factor x squared minus 4x plus 3?
X minus 3, x minus 1.
So after you factor, you can take an LCM. At least not an multiple. I'm going to compare these, so I need a 2. 2's got to be there. Check, I need an x minus 1. Okay, here is the first one. I go to the second one. I need an x minus 3. Check. I need an x minus 1. Oh, already there. Check. That's the answer.
Number four. Okay, let's see. What do you need to factor 4 squared minus 16?
Yeah, it could be 2x plus 1, 2x minus 4. There's one other way.
That is right. It's just
a, yeah, take a 4.
Yeah.
No, how do I factor what's left in parentheses? You factor and factor again.
X minus 2.
Uh-huh. And x plus 2. Alright, how should I factor 6x?
Take out
6. Factor again. Melena, can you factor this one too?
I get a 2? Or, oh, no.
Negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. Negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4. That's the factor form. When you hear people say they can't do this, it's usually because they can't factor. Encourage them to come get a factoring worksheet. LCM. So when I'm taking LCM, I'm comparing this factored form and this factored form. So I'll start with the numbers. 4 and 6. If I had to add fractions 1 4th and 1 6th, what would the common denominator be? 24. 12 or 24 would work. If you pick 24, your numbers will be higher. You can probably reduce at the end. It's okay. Problem will be right. So 12 is the right answer. 24 works. Reduce it at the end. Okay. So 4 and 6 are both inside 12 right now. They're in there. Okay. We also have to list x minus 2. We also have to list x plus 2. Okay. So the 6 goes into the 12. I gotta go here now. X minus 2 is here. Is there another x minus 2? No, there's not. This one's already been taken, so I'll have to list it again. The only time you list the same factor twice is if it's twice in one term. Yeah.
So what do you mean when you say, like, the 6 and 4 inside of the
12? Just like this. Just go back to a simple example. If I asked you to add these two fractions, what would the denominator be?
Oh, wait, 12.
Well,
And that's because 4 can go into 12, and 6 can go into 12.
24 would work though.
That's because 4 can go into 12, and 6 can go into 12, right? Like here, I can multiply 3 and multiply 2 and create 12. So they're inside there. Okay?
Can you just square
the
x minus 2?
You could. And in my final answer, I would. But when I go to add, actually, I think this might be easier to write.
Oh, yeah, I get that.
Yeah, you can. Had this not been listed twice here, there would only be one x minus 2.
Okay.
If it's a twin and one polynomial, you have to list twins here. So if you have twins, you're gonna have twins here. If you don't, you don't. Alright, so we're doing 1 through 14 on page 703.
Woo! I literally predicted that.
Me too. I actually thought I did that right. I know. Imagine after 3 quarters being able to predict the number. But I'm glad you didn't work ahead.
Me too.
Me too. I'm lost.
Yeah.